All right, let's talk about a few of the other cross grip throws. We've covered sasai, tsurukumiyashi. We've covered osorogaki. Okay, here are a few of the others. Cross grip technique. Sumigeshi, let me do the traditional sumigeshi first of all. Sumigeshi, we take jigo hante, defensive stance, wide stance. Drive his leg back, and now I'm simply going to sit underneath his feet and put my shin up into his thigh. Great competition move, but a more successful move is off the cross grip. Again, get control of the head. Pull the head and arm in tightly. Now rather than getting my right shin into his left thigh, I'm going to take my left shin into his left thigh. And I'm going to get a half jujigatami armbar on the finale here. Again, sit down. Is that all in the tape?
Yep.
Okay, this is a half jujigatami. I get the... got some fur in there. Get some, get the little finger pointed toward the hip. And then I play the lock against the elbow using my hip up into his elbow. So it's this technique. I should show you full jujigatami at this point, which is laid down on your back. Jujigatami, or cross mark hold, taken traditionally, very tightly bring the shin in against the ribs and bring the heel against the neck. Sit down as close to his body as possible. Keep his little finger pulled into your chest. Rise up with your hips to apply the lock. A stronger competition move would be to scissor the legs, or actually capture both hands and scissors both arms within the legs. Pulling the knees together, he can roll, and it's virtually impossible for him to escape this move as long as I can keep the feet secure. Of course, once the feet do break open, he can throw a leg over and escape if I don't keep the pressure on. Okay, one of the other nice cross grip techniques is a variation of kosodagari. Kosodagari, simply sweeping from the inside, drawing it across, and pushing him down. Kosodagaki, I feel, is more effective because it traps the leg very tightly. A little harder to resist. But anyway, off a cross grip, and this is one bronze medalist Ed Liddy really loves. Off a cross grip, we want to drive his head down, and we want to run across and kick a field goal with that far foot. Yeah. Simply spreading his feet apart. Once his base gets to a certain point, spread your feet apart. He becomes very unstable and it's easy to push him down. Okay. Get my cross grip. Come across, kick. Down he goes. Stay at this side. Again, it's important to keep the pressure on the head. And from this position, it's very easy to win a judo tournament. Now let's talk about throws that would be good for self-defense. Any of these throws would be fine until you hit the ground. The problem is, in judo, sport judo I should say, most of the throws are going to take a person down onto his back. You don't necessarily want a person on the back in self-defense. In fact, I would imagine most people would prefer to have a person take him down onto his stomach. So here are a few of the judo takedown techniques onto the stomach. Some of the easiest and most basic are walking the tummy armbar. He reaches the arm across and right through. Okay? Walking the tummy armbar, as in all arm straightener arm bars, we want to apply pressure not just to the elbow joint, we want to apply pressure about an inch and a half above the elbow joint and work on the tendons that connect to the tricep. What will happen is you press against these tendons, causes tremendous pain, causes the tricep to seize up, and actually helps your arm work. So with walking tatami, I take the wrist with an inverted grip. That is, inverted grip meaning forefinger and thumbs toward his hand. Normal grip would be this way, with forefinger and thumbs toward the elbow. Inverted grip, drawing it out, bringing the little finger towards the sky, Now I know the elbow's going to be in the right position for walking tummy. Bring it down. Okay? From a straight armbar position on the mat, drive my knee in here. Bring it across. If I want to turn him over, if I want to keep him on his back, I just simply keep this leg in here, across the inside here, and I work on the wrist. Okay, it's a very painful move. Some of the other techniques, I've developed a lot of names for techniques, English names. For instance, Shihonage. Okay, the Shihonage I just call outside spinner throw. First way I teach is from a handshake position. Here, and of course, you got foot in here, you got a nice takedown technique and a nice arm breaker and wrist breaker. If I want to sit down with it, it's extremely painful. Again, against multiple assailants, you don't go that far down. That was outside spinner. Inside spinner, again, a wrist lock, and again, I'm propping against the head. All right, these are a few of the armbar takedowns. There's a couple more bent armbars that are very effective. For example, if he was to grab my wrist, say it was grab right here. This is a very nice move into a nice bent elbow arm lock. Swing along here, grab up here, and I have a nice armbar takedown. Okay, wrist locks, getting back to wrist locks. Kote gaeshi, basic to any jujutsu, certainly to Kotokan Goshi jutsu. Many variations of this too. I can show you a dozen of just about anything you see. Getting back to some of the straight arm bars, we've got arm locks this way. Okay? There's basically four ways a wrist can be locked out. Inside up, inside down, outside up, and outside down. And there's a lot of variations to get people into various techniques. Okay? Okay, from this technique, many difficult throws for him to take, so I won't throw with him.